Welcome to the Swing Trading with Cycles channel. We're going to do our update on the Dixie today, the US dollar index. It is April 23rd, 2023. It's a Sunday. This is the weekend update. And as always, take a look at the pinned comment. That'll give you previous videos about the Dixie, but also other asset classes. We review them all. They're a playlist. They're all organized by playlist. And also your background on cycles and important price action concepts like swing highs and swing lows, because those are the turning points of the market. And so speaking of swing highs and swing lows, this is our last swing high on day 24 of the cycle. That was March 8th. This is the US dollar index. Again, this is your daily chart. And you can see since that swing high on that day, we've had a very clear downtrend, which is to say a daily cycle decline. That's a lower high. That's another lower high. That's another lower high. And then this so far is a swing low on day 51. And what day is that? That is April 14th. And so assuming this is your daily cycle low, Friday would have been day 5. But notice this has all just been consolidation inside the range of this candle, which was followed through off of this move, right? So just to be clear, we made a lower low on that day, April 14th. And then we made a lower low below this low. You know, you can actually, if we draw a quick line there, you can kind of see like right there, right? So that's your sort of false breakdown and then reversal, bullish reversal. And then the next day you actually had follow through. But then for the next 4 days, they're all inside the range of this candle, you know, very clearly. And so we got to break out of this range, right? Very, very simple. The high is 102.231 and the low is 101.531. And of course, the higher time frame trend is down for sure. So you have to remember that surprises come to the downside. That said, on this lower time frame, this is something of a little bull flag. So a move above 102.231. You know, you could see yourself testing, you know, one of these lower highs here. And this is day 5. The thing is, this is already day 5 of the daily cycle. So it's already burned some time. And so even if we get a little breakout, you could see a world where, you know, we get a top on like day 10, let's say, and then we continue sort of the rollover. Like, look at this. This was a top on day 5, for instance. This was a top on day. Well, this was a weird. Yeah, you could say this was a top on day 11, really. And then you kind of trended lower, and this was all one cycle that would have been like 32 days, right? So all that to say, we're relatively early in a new daily cycle, most likely. You see how we're kind of clustering above and below the 10-day moving average, and so we could get a little bit more of a rally here. That would probably be a flush lower for the metals as well, but then the metals would print their DCL, this would print its DCH, and continue the trend lower. And if we look at the weekly chart, importantly, this important swing high here back at the end of September 2022 was your 3-year cycle high. And since then, we've been in a nice, big, clean downtrend. You had this big leg lower here, right? Like a big leg down with almost no bounces, very few bounces. Again, this is your weekly chart. And then we've had this little bounce here, which petered out on week 5. So the same way we had that top on day 24, this was week 5 of the weekly cycle. So again, watch that video, tons of alpha in there. The cycles are nested within each other. So we just finished week 11. And so if you think about weekly levels now, we really need, for the bullish case to mean anything, we need to break above here, right? So we need to break above this candle here, that candle's high. So that's 102.807. And because we're in a bearish trend, you could see that area becoming resistance. You know, anything from like 102.807 to, let's say, like, yeah, basically 103.180, something like that. Like, you know, it's going to be a zone, a range. But that, again, so just to be clear, again, the other thing is that because this is week 11, it's uncommon to get a low. That would mean that this was a week 10 low. That would be very uncommon. Generally, the cycles are more in the 20 to 30 week range, not as short as 10 weeks. So the expectation, to be clear, again, we started this really clean downtrend. Boom, we got this little bounce. This is your potential double bottom. That would get bulls really excited. And so you maybe see something like this. This is your, and this would be your daily cycle advance. And then we make a lower low, retest this point, fail, make another lower low, and just continue on down for the rest of the year, because we're in a long-term downtrend. And we'll look at the other higher time frame charts as well, but that would be the expectation. And so it's really a question of how high does this bounce last? And obviously, if this bounce were to get above here, that might be a game changer. That could still lead to lower lows and be a fake out, a false breakout of this area here. But that's something we want to watch for. At some point, you know, if the higher time frame trend is changing, then we have to change as well. But right now, this is clearly a bearish setup on that higher time frame. And again, because it's only week 11, you could easily see a world where we get, let's just say we get our sort of garden variety 11-week cycle. Let's see, where would that put us? So this was, if we go to, so that would give us our low around June 19th. That's interesting. And that would mean that basically we topped out on week 5 and we'll continue to decline for another, call it 15 weeks. Again, last week being week 11. And let's look at the monthly chart. We'll see that the context of the 3-year cycle is even clearer on this chart. So you can see this was the furious rally for this 3-year cycle. Right, it lasted 20 months. That's what this 20 means. So that was September when we topped out. So we had a furious rally for 20 months, and now we're in the declining phase. This is month 27, this April. I mean, look at this chart. I'll get rid of these lines, make it easier for us to just see this. And you can see this line here, that's when this candle, this September candle, officially became a swing high. And you knew with very strong evidence that we were beginning a downtrend on the monthly chart, which is now a downtrend on the quarterly chart. But I hope you can see that, right? I mean, we've been talking about this on this channel for a little bit. Again, remember we talked about that clean move down? This is the monthly chart version of it. Again, this is the multiple time frame analysis. So we had this clean move down and then this bounce. I mean, we even had a green month. I mean, look at that green candle. The presumption now is that this bounce is over on the monthly chart, and we are going to make a lower low below that one. And at some point, we'll get another bounce in the monthly chart, of course, before our final low, or I mean, maybe a few more bounces even, because in a downtrend, price does bounce. And so we would expect that. But it's only week month 27, and so we generally would expect the low around month 36, something like that. So that puts us at like early January 2024, or call it early 2024. You can see some of these previous, like, so the 3-year cycle right before this one was, I mean, look at this. We rallied for 25 months versus the 20-month rally here. But I mean, in terms of the actual upside, it was like minimal versus this. I mean, look, this is like straight up, right? And so this lasted 35 months. It doesn't mean this one has to last exactly 35 months, but it's unlikely that it'll be really short. And so that means we're probably going to be in a downtrend. Or I should say, if we're only on month 27, I mean, you would think we're at least going to get to like month 30. So still quite a bit of downside awaits in terms of time. And we'll see if that means the same for price. And you can see this period before was much longer, 45 months. And it, I mean, this is kind of an ugly situation. We have this kind of consolidation zone here, this breakdown, which ended up being a false breakdown that made a higher high above here, but then we collapsed below these lows. And you can even see, look at this little bounce here. This is a perfect example of a nice little mid-decline lower high. Like, oh, okay, maybe we're out of the woods. No, we're not. Lower low. So you can kind of see that on this chart. You can, we may get a few more of these. These are all other 3-year cycle declines. Like, look at this decline. Look at that decline. That was a weird one. I mean, this cycle as a whole was kind of weird. I mean, look at this decline. Yikes. I mean, look at this bounce back. Now, this is a crazy one. Like, that would really get a lot of people offside. So you get this big move down after a 12-month rally, and then you have this huge move up and a massive epic double top, and then we make a lower low in the end to make a low on month 38. These are scenarios that you wanna have in mind. Look at this decline. Yikes. We topped out on month 11 and then just woof. We dropped for another, 28 months into a month 39 low. So all that to say, it doesn't have to be exactly 35 months by any means, but this gives you a sense of some of the ranges. And so this is going to be a great trade throughout the rest of the year. UUP is the way to get exposure to this. I play this through call spreads and put spreads, depending on the situation, mostly put spreads, as you might imagine. But sometimes you get, this was a nice little furious bounce where call spreads could work, but this kind of tells you we could be visiting like the 26 level on this thing. And where did we close here? So we are at 27.75. So that's a nice bit of downside because, you know, the IV on those contracts is, you know, minimal. And we're talking about getting contracts for like cents. So could be a lot of upside here. So that's the update on the Dixie. Let's quickly look at some yields. Generally, yields appear to be moving higher. Let's look at the actual 10-year yield itself, the chart. So this is your monthly chart. And you can see we had this massive move lower. What month is that? Right, that's your March 2020 sort of capitulation low. And then just look at this massive rally. I mean, you can see the uptrend is so clear. Up, down, up, tiny little bit of consolidation, up. And so now it's a question of what happens after this? Do we get that? There's no reason why we couldn't. And like the structure of this chart suggests that that is actually a more likely scenario. And if you kind of, and we'll zoom into the actual, you know, like looking at the detail of this, but I mean, this is all the look of a bull flag. And you can see the monthly has just gone green, right? Essentially that becomes a false breakdown. You see that? Let me get rid of that line. We make a slight lower low below this cluster of lows, really. And now we're trying to reverse to the upside. That tells you, at least for the short term, yields are going higher. This is your 10-year yield. Let's look at the weekly, because that tells us where we might be in the weekly cycle. Right, so that tells me that this could be a weekly cycle low here. Let's get rid of these lines, make that easier to see. Right, so that's your sort of lower low, your false breakdown. And now we've made a higher high on this weekly. So, but it's pulled back since. And so very clear that we need to get above, call it 3.646 on the 10-year yield. And that opens you up to retest this high here at 4%, basically. So break above 3.646 could take you to 4%. Again, that could certainly be a double top. This has been mostly kind of rangy. But at least in the short term, this looks like we may have a sort of a weekly cycle low here. And that's your 10-year yield. Are we seeing a similar thing for the 30? Kind of, but not really. So interestingly enough, the 30 is not a lower low. It's actually a higher low. You can see this is just, you can even kind of draw it here if you wanted, if you're, you know, trend line guy. You can see that, right? That is, you know, moving higher clearly. So this is actually even more suggestive of a move higher. That's your 30-year yield. And let's look at the monthly on the 30-year yield. So the same kind of thing where, and I was doing some analysis on this previously, obviously, but same kind of idea, right? You have this big move up and then this like this was many months of downside. But then look at this furious move out of that little consolidation. What ended up being a consolidation of this up move. And so now the question is this just a consolidation of this up move? Certainly looks like a bull flag. And again, you have the monthly chart, the monthly candle has gone green. It was red, now it's green. And the proximate way to play this, one of the proximate ways is TBT. I think there certainly are other vehicles, but let's look at TBT real quick. It is leveraged, so I don't love that. But this is an inverse for bond prices, which is what you want because you think bond prices are going to go down, yields are going to go up. And so you can see the monthly has gone green on this one, and it is a false breakdown. So this low here was at 26.73, and we broke down to 2657. Yeah. So this is setting up for a move above the high of this candle, so 3275. That's nice upside there. That's a nice little trade, and it's a kind of a macro trade a little bit. Obviously, you have the Fed meeting coming up. That feels to me like the next big catalyst that's coming up in May at some point. Because the broader market itself has been, you know, kind of muted, very, very small range candle this month. So that's the setup there. TBT looks like it might be a nice trade. I'm going to look into some other ETFs because, again, I think the vehicle one uses to play this is really important. And, of course, this means TLT is not looking so great. And I think I tweeted about this, or certainly in the last update we talked about this. Look at this range, right? Just been in a range. And you can argue, well, this is a little bull flag off of this move. Well, yeah, has to prove it, right? The question is, do we visit the lower end of this range at 99? Even if we do that, that's a nice little bit of downside from where we closed here at 104, right? So that's another 4% down. So that's not great for if you're bullish. So, you know, while it's, again, still inside this consolidation box, that does tell you proximate. Let's look at the daily chart. That tells you, like, near term, we probably do have downside. And we talked about this, how there are gaps below. So this is your daily chart. So this is important. We have a bearish outside candle on the daily chart. So that definitely is suggestive of a gap fill. So down to 103. And then there's another gap between 101 and 99.68. So that's your scenario where you get back to that lower end of the range. These gaps certainly help, right? Like that could kind of help price along. Like, oh, there's a gap right here just kind of waiting for you. So this now becomes, a put spread kind of situation on TLT or outright long on TBT. Those are, you know, different vehicles to potentially kind of play this trade. Look at this epic topping situation. And people talk about, well, there's no such thing as a triple top, which is what this would be, right? This top, that top, that top. And now we have this little kind of abandoned candle. I mean, yikes, look at that swing high. Just to be clear, that's what that is, a big old swing high. Look at that. Yikes. So that's interesting. This is this between the dollar, and I like this because these are sort of more macro trades, not like on an individual company or anything like that. But I like this setup here for downside on TLT. So that's the update here. Thanks for watching.